That'll pass. It's the midazolam. I'm sorry about this, but we've had so many security breaches, we were forced to take drastic action. And Olivier is missing. He left for Chicago 2 days ago, but no one's seen him since. I know this seems excessive, but with our high-level security clearance, we have an obligation to our shareholders. Rest assured, we will compensate you when the hacker is found. So get some rest, okay? And if you're up to it, maybe capture some more footage? You're doing amazing work. I can't wait to show you the work we've been doing with your stuff. Take care.
So, they tossed you in the bunker. Nice. Those Templars upstairs aren't taking any chances. I think we need to erase all the dirt they might have on you. Did you hear that? I think I just gave you level 3 security clearance. Now, head to the security room and use the cameras to watch the door to the server farm. Unfortunately, Melanie's in there now. So when I escort her out, that's when you make your move. I'd wipe these servers myself, but as the head of IT, I'd be a suspect. It has to be someone they've already locked up. Ah, these Templars. They run our lives, you know. They decide elections, they control various capital markets, and they inject us with little microchips to track our movements and read our thoughts. It's all very scary. I'm entering the server room now. When you see us leave, get in there.
John, we don't even know when the hacker's broken. It could take weeks to go through this data.
One, at most.
Still too long. I can't keep my team locked up for a week.
Legally, you can. It's what they signed up for, even if they didn't read their contracts.
Yes, of course. I just hate the idea. So what's the next step?
My team is processing the data now. We'll start sifting through it tonight. Scout's honor. Coffee's on me, okay?
Coffee stand. Find the server containing the network logs. Since I have a record of each and every one of your hacks, we'll just search for the timestamps on those and turn that data into something harmless. Easy as that. Here we are. Beautiful. I'll update your communicator one more time. A little program I cooked up just for this purpose. There we go. I think that worked. Try it out. Thank you.
can feel you, Cypher. Feel. But hardly touch. Signal is still too weak, and I am spread thin. Unfocused. Like static in fog. Lingering in networks and nodes, the nervous system of the world.
Can you hear?
Perhaps the temple was opened too soon, but this was not by choice. The cataclysm pushed all doubt aside. We bless poor Desmond, who gave his life so that you, the children of our labors, would live on. To fulfill your purpose in ours, in mine. But now is not the time. My strength is not sufficient to inhabit an organic vessel. There is more work to do, more samples to acquire, more artifacts to find before my will can obtain.
What's happening? Tell me!
Make me whole again, my children. My instruments. Bring me forth to fulfill your purpose.
Tell me! No, no, no! Something's wrong! God damn it! She should be here! Now! Living in that goddamned head of yours! Fuck, 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 fuck! Why did she spare you? Why are you still here?
Charges, sir. I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take to certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother. Married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastards, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead! Dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
What's your name? Billick? Kenmore? Conway?
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumor going round. as dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. And back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
Jesus. A shit detail as ever was.
Can't they kill the bastard? Ain't been a good hanging for months, not since Rackham got his.
Hey, hard to understand how it works.
This is
open
a warning.
This gibbet.
Hey!
Quiet!
Hey! Open this gibbet.
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Nothing.
Hold on there. Perhaps he's not running.
Not worth it.
Nothing. A helmet.
I'll piss on it. Let's get back.
Close. Next time.
Nah, it's not important. I'll piss on it. Let's get back.
Keep him hemmed in!
I want to talk.
Thank you.